Such a treat to be here with you guys tonight. I don't know if all of you realize this, but I actually got my start in performing again with Cabaret. I had taken a hiatus that turned into a very, very long one that I wasn't intending. In 2012, I was involved in a production of Ed Wood movies adapted for the stage. There's some people here tonight who were in it who know this story. It was 5 Ed Wood movies adapted for the stage that ran in rep for 3 weeks, and as if that doesn't sound terrifying enough, there was no stage manager, no props master, no costume designer, no assistant director, nothing to help us. The director himself had spread himself so thin in just trying to put this thing on its feet that the actors ended up having to step in and do all these jobs for ourselves. I will never forget tearing my fingers to ribbons, trying to make an atom smasher for a show that I wasn't even really part of, because out of a colander, a hand fan, and steel wool, because if I didn't do this half an hour before the show opened, it wasn't gonna get done. So when it was all over, I took a step back and I said, all right, this has been a huge ordeal. Take 6 months off. And that 6 months turned into 4 years. And in talking through this, I think I realized what my actual greatest fear is. It's being forgotten. I know this is something that actually drives a lot of us to perform and also, you know, get involved in different parts of the arts. You wanna be immortal in the minds of other, like, be remembered in the minds of other people. The other side of this is when you're trying to get back into things, it's cripplingly terrifying because everyone you've worked with, it seems, has forgotten about you, and what's the point of even trying, and you're gonna have to crawl your way back out of the ditch that you've put yourself in, and it's just a nightmare. So in December of 2015, Mel Delancey, and yes, that is the correct name in the timeline of this story, posted on Facebook that she was gonna be doing a cabaret and she was looking for performers. And Mel and I really barely knew each other. I think I'd been to an Oscar party at her bar and said maybe 10 words to her, but I sent her a message saying, hey, I'd love to perform in your show. And it was the scariest thing I think I'd done. And she responded and said, I'd love to have you. And we did 7 cabarets together the following year in 2016. And that led to me working with dysfunctional theater, which then led to me being in a production of The Bacchae on Governor's Island, which then led to the calendar. Told you I was gonna talk about it again. It also led to me meeting Nicole after one of Mel's cabarets. We were hanging out at Grape and Vine, whatever that fucking place was, next door. And Nicole, in all of her terrifying glory, comes sidling up to me and goes, hey, you're really good, we should say something. And I was like, shit, Nicole knows who I am and doesn't want to murder me. Double bonus. And this also led to me getting back in the scene enough to join the cast of It's Getting Tired, Mildred, which has its 44th episode on next Saturday, whatever date that is, November 9th?
November 9th.
Thank you, Roger. I don't know what day it is. So it's been great. So I know that Mel is here tonight. Melissa McGuire, as she goes by now, is here tonight. And I'm sure she's sitting in her chair like, oh, she's totally gonna dedicate this song to me. Earned it! Trick, bitch! You know I like to turn things on their head. So to everyone facing down that horrible fear, this song's for you. I don't know why I'm frightened. I know my way around here. The cardboard trees, the painted seas, the sound here. Yes, a world to rediscover, but I'm not in any hurry, and I need a in overcrowded hallways, the atmosphere has been coming up.